This is a vlog about materials, and more specifically, these four materials. MDF, metal mesh, mold-injected plastic, and tennis ball felt. Obviously, two of these materials are not things that we associate with buildings and construction materials, but I think it's important to remember that everyday objects weather as well. And I think we kind of forget that. And I think that maybe, yeah, I'll come to the same conclusions at the end of the semester as if I had studied something more commonly used in buildings, but maybe I can have more fun coming to the same conclusions this semester by maybe learning to study objects and their weathering patterns, as well as interior, exterior, wherever it is, whatever its function has a pattern of wearing and weathering. And it can be, I don't know, pretty fun maybe to try to find out just where that deviates from a normal building's weather pattern timeline, or in effect or in interaction, stuff like that. So we'll see.
That'd be me.
Then yeah, probably me. Medium density fiberboard. I really just wanna kind of experiment with it. I think it's pretty normal compared to other things that I've got, but I don't know, learn a little bit about it. It's not too often exposed, usually kind of veneered or hidden back, but I'm interested in sort of learning its capabilities beyond just being milled or used in the woodshop. Metal mesh is, I don't know, very exciting to me. I don't have a lot to show for it. I think I'm most excited just in the fact that I don't know anything about it. So for this video, which is sort of a material introduction, I kind of have nothing to say. But I think the fact that I have nothing to say means that it may be able to actually teach me the most. Not too often find this in buildings, but I think that how to use it, how to layer it, would be very exciting, and sort of what happens to it once it is left outside. This is my second material, and I really sort of interact with this quite a bit, and I'm just really interested in sort of learning a little bit more about how it interacts sort of with the sun and just being outside
because they change color, and I think it's very interesting that for an outdoor sport, sort of the main object is something which has a pretty short lifespan outside. I also think it's pretty interesting that sort of this thing is seen as so fragile. I mean, it's really not, but its relationship with the environment is, as soon as it opens out of the can and is exposed to air, it's sort of been tainted, and the life cycle sort of begins, and then a timer starts before it inevitably dies. And I think it's really interesting that there can be an object that's made to be so resilient to forces, sort of human forces, but maybe not to natural forces. And I don't know, I just think it's really unique and kind of fun. This is disc golf, and a lot like regular golf or architecture, people really get addicted to the form, and they want to do it again, and again, and again, and again, and again, and again, until they finally get that perfect shot. This is my idea here of mold-injected plastic. And you can see it really does kind of get worn down pretty well here. And I think a little bit like maybe a stone wall, it sort of ages pretty beautifully. It's still in perfect working condition, exactly how I would have wanted it when I bought it, but there's a bit of a relationship built up between me and this that maybe doesn't exist elsewhere. You can't even see me right now, but I'm here, like usual, at the park, kind of just collecting my thoughts for the evening, and I don't know, it just crossed my mind. I think I've been too happy this semester so far. I've been smiling too much, and maybe I won't be smiling at finals, but I don't know, it's weird. I gotta get less vitamin D, I guess.